Today we'll be discussing the Corbin Burbank Iceberg. Now, Corbin Burbank, he is a musical artist who makes albums and remixes. How do I describe him? Most of the stuff that I need to describe is on this iceberg. But yeah. Alright, let's actually get on to the iceberg.
Corbin's real name. Corbin's real name is Dylan Ward. This is pretty obvious stuff. That's why it's this high on the iceberg. Because literally, you could just look up Corbin Burbank on Google and get the name. Origami and Ugly. Origami and Ugly are two of the albums that are still up to this day, as he says that he is incredibly proud of them. Origami having 17 songs and Ugly having 46. Bandcamp. Bandcamp is where he published most of his albums, including the ones that do not make it onto streaming services. More on that later. But the Bandcamp is where the music is getting for free, and also involves the remixes as well. Instagram. Instagram is the only social media that he has, let alone uses. And he isn't gone by Corbin Burbank. More on that later as well. Layer 2 of the iceberg. This is where stuff gets really crazy, and I can stop talking about this. Really easy to get information. Other names. Corbin Burbank goes by other names, such as Bobby Malone, Casino Hearts, and even Morningstar. These names are pretty much his most popular names. There's also a few others that not that many people know about. Park Street View and Someday Cyborg. Koin Koi 2 are albums that have been deleted off the Bandcamp, but you can still stream them today, which we'll get on that later as well. The thing about these are, they had some of his beloved songs, examples being 2012 and Box Cutter. The reason he deleted these albums are unknown. Sal Sterling. Sal Sterling is one of his biggest friends to date, as he constantly contacts him and Sal contacts him. And the best part about Salas is that he actually gives some of his albums, previews, and unreleased albums to Silas for him to re-upload. More on that later. Streaming. Corbin Burbank's albums are on streaming services, sometimes under Morningstar, sometimes under Corbin. And the streaming services range from Apple Music, Amazon Prime, to Spotify, and a few others as well. But unluckily, some of the albums have been deleted off of streaming. Layer 3. This is where shit starts to get a little bit, you know, people and things that having less views than his own music, surprisingly, but are honestly pretty important to Morningstar. But he doesn't exactly like them. Morningstar Archive. Morningstar Archive is a thing that Salas has done where Salas had almost every single one of his albums, and why not archive them, as some of them aren't even on streaming services or up to download. If it wasn't for him, he would have had lost media. The Morningstar Archive, consisting of 255 songs, with the last one recently being uploaded is Volume 0.5, more on that later. Koi B-Sides. Koi B-Sides is an album that has been on the Bandcamp, but not on streaming services, and it's been one of the albums that has been deleted off the Bandcamp, but luckily, because of Morningstar Archives, we have the entire album. Not a Speedrunner. Not a Speedrunner is a Siva Gunner ripoff channel where he makes rips, and his most popular rips being the Morningstar ones, as he used older music when they were deleted before the Morningstar Archive existed. I said archive, weird. Fool, Unreleased. Fool Unreleased is an album that was going to be with Origami and Ugly, coming after Ugly, coming before Origami. The problem is, it was scrapped when it was finished. So, even though it has the tag unfinished, it is finished. This is one of the albums that Morningstar has given to Silas, and luckily Silas has uploaded it so the world can hear this album. The reason why Morningstar has scrapped the album was he thought the songs were not that good. This was during the time when Koi and his other albums were deleted. We're starting to get into some deep waters here, so be prepared. Changed album covers. Corbin Burbank is known to change his album covers from time to time. Good example is the ugly cover. On Bandcamp, it looks like this, and on streaming services, it looks like this. It's weird how he does this, as this doesn't change anything. VOL 0.5. VOL 0.5, or volume 0.5, is the hardest album to listen to, as the only way to listen to it is to either buy it or listen to it on Amazon. Luckily, Silas has archived it after getting Amazon Prime, and now we can listen to the album easily without having to worry about having Amazon Prime. It is also the first album that he has made, being made in 2017 while being uploaded to streaming services in 2018. Sampled Minecraft. Morningstar has sampled Minecraft from time to time. I can't give any examples because I don't know what was used for sampling, but Morningstar has gone on record saying he has sampled Minecraft before. YouTube. Morningstar / Corbin Burbank has a YouTube where he uploads music videos. There's also a Corbin Burbank / Morningstar topic, but that's just re-uploads of the albums that he's put on streaming services. All the music videos have been archived in case of deletion, under Morningstar Archive. We are now on the fifth layer. This is where stuff starts to get really unknown. So strap in. Breast album cover. The original album cover for XTCY Flip, not the Kanye one, but the earlier version of it, the original album art was of a pair of breasts, then getting changed to a screenshot from LSD Dream Emulator, being back to the breast before getting deleted and replaced with Kanye XTCY Flip. Lost banners. Morningstar has a fuck ton of banners that have been lost. These banners are from the Bandcamp at the top of the screen. Luckily, from Internet Archive pages, and not a speedrunner using one of them as his album cover for Morningstar rips, we can safely say we have only like 4 of them. He has like 50. Girlfriend? Morningstar / Corbin Burbank has been pictured with a girl several times in his more recent Instagram posts. It's unclear if that's his girlfriend or just some random girl he likes to hang out with, as he has not gone on record saying that she is his girlfriend. At least I don't think he did. I didn't do too much research on him himself. Caitlin / Nick. These are two of his friends he doesn't exactly contact anymore, which is pretty sad, as they were pretty unique people, saying from personal experience, because I was friends with them too. There is a rumor that Caitlin still does message him, but it's unclear if she actually does or not. Sex. Sex. So. I can't, this is like my fourth fucking attempt. Alright, so it's pretty unclear if he has had sex or not. What I find even funnier is that this is higher than the smoking one. But yeah, it's pretty unfucking clear if he's had sex before. Most likely he has if he hangs out with a girl, but I don't fucking know anymore. Layer 6. This is after the sex one. Song getting leaked. During the Morningstar archive that was happening, Silas accidentally uploaded a song called Smoke Break, which was going to be used in Origami. It was under 2020 songs. Sadly, he had to remove 2020 songs before he uploaded Origami, but luckily we have both 2020 songs and Origami. So, there are now 2 copies of Smoke Break because of that. Smoking. It's a pretty well-known fact that Morningstar / Corbin Burbank smokes, as shown from album covers and even some Instagram posts. Sadly, this could mean that Morningstar could die pretty early into his life, but at least we'll have some banging music. Origami demo names. The names for Origami demos is incredibly weird and unorganized. Morningstar has told Silas that the reason they're named like that was because that's what the file names were called, so there's no hidden ARG shit in it. Unused Ugly songs. When Morningstar Archive was about to archive Ugly, he archived a few other songs that weren't on the album, under Ugly Unreleased Songs. Some of the songs are actually pretty good, good example, Thoughts and Prayers. But these didn't make it because Morningstar didn't like them. The only reason Salas even has these Morningstar songs is because Morningstar given him the album before it was even finished. We're starting to get into stuff that almost nobody knows about, so get ready. Album art question mark is a thing that Salas likes to do, where he posts a random picture and asks Morningstar if it could be album art, which most of the time is no. Toilet. Salas has posted a picture tagging Morningstar in a picture of a toilet in the middle of what's to be nowhere. But this toilet actually does have a story, as Salas and Morningstar went to an abandoned building, finding a toilet and taking a picture of it, calling it a haunted toilet. Salas has went to Call Me Carson to give it to him to see if he would make Cursed Toilets number 2, sadly not using that picture, and not even being able to enter Carson's DMs on Discord. Hey Bobby Malone IG. Hey Bobby Malone IG, or Hey Bobby Malone's Instagram account, is an account that's set to private, but if Hey Bobby Malone, aka Morningstar, allows you to enter it, it's just a bunch of shitposts. There's nothing special about it, besides really off-putting pictures. School entrance 3-mile mark. School entrance 3-mile mark is a rip that not a speeder has uploaded, but the album cover for this image is a picture of Morningstar dabbing. This picture is nowhere else on the internet besides that one album art. There's nothing special to it though. Morningstar 5 miles. There's a picture that Salas has uploaded saying not a speeder and a Morningstar walking 5 miles to go to a friend's house. What happened during that was not a speedrunner and Morningstar walked 5 miles to her friend's house, and then realizing they had to walk 5 miles back to their houses. It was a god-awful day, said not a speedrunner. We're on the last layer here, and this is pretty much unknown shit. Unreleased music. Like with the full album, Morningstar has a fuck ton of unreleased music. A lot of it being lost media, as he refuses to give it to Salas or, again, release it. But Salas does know that one of them was a Lavender Town remix. Morningstar shirtless. There are several pictures of Morningstar being shirtless in these weird locations. Nobody knows where these locations are, one of them even being possibly torn down. Thanking Salas for re-uploading songs. When Never Neverland was re-uploaded, Morningstar personally thanked Salas for re-uploading it, as that song was deleted everywhere off the internet, and not even having access to it himself. If it wasn't for Salas, this would be one of the lost media songs. V-Deadboy. V-Deadboy is the studio that Morningstar uses. V-Deadboy not being a real fucking studio in the first place, and the studio that he releases music to is Route Note, as shown in the description of his songs that go under the Corbin Burbank / Morningstar topic channels. Silas Only Info and Sojourner Moon Song. These two go together because Sojourner Moon Song is part of Silas Only Info. But Silas Only Info is the information that only Silas knows, mainly DMs and stuff. The Sojourner Moon Song being a song that Morningstar has worked on with Silas, and using samples from Sojourner Moon and Hilltop Zone from Sonic 2. Sadly, he didn't even download it to put it on his Bandcamp, so this song is lost for good. And that was the Corbin Burbank Iceberg. I hope you guys actually really enjoyed this. This is one of the very few videos that I actually put time and quality into, and yeah. Also, some of these things were actually really hard to describe. Good example was V-Dead Studios, the Morningstar shirtless stuff, and the 5 miles Morningstar, because I was a part of that, because, fun fact, I'm not a speedrunner, but I was actually a part of the 5 mile thing, and I remember almost nothing of that day. I do remember it was either me or Morningstar crying. I actually do remember that. I think it was me crying, because like I didn't want to walk another 5 fucking miles back home. It took a good like 2 hours. Yeah, but yeah, that's basically all of it.